All right, welcome girls. And I am super, super duper excited and honored that we have Miss Angela. Is it Angelia?
It's Angeli.
Angeli, okay, that's what I thought, but you have an A at the end.
I know, girl. Listen, ask my mama, okay? It's pronounced Angeli. You can also call me Angie, and I'm not super sensitive about it. It's a great conversation piece.
Okay, perfect. Well, because I know that everyone calls you Angeli, and I was like, well, it has an A at the end. So maybe I was like hearing wrong. So we have Miss Angelia Robinson. She is from Texas, and she is a multi-entrepreneur because she has extra passions. So which means you can have more than one passion and still be super, super, super successful. So some fun facts about Miss Angeli is that she is 48. Look at her. Does she even look like she's 48? No, right? Oh my gosh. Like you're going to be like, you have like really good skin. You have a great smile. You have some great energy. Aww. She is married and she has 5 kids, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of them. So 3 of them are boys and 2 of them are girls. Her oldest is 28 and she has the youngest at 7. No wonder why you're so young, because you have to stay so active.
I was going to say that, right? The kids keep you young. That's what they say.
That's what they say.
Yep.
And some fun facts. And this was really kind of interesting for me. She is a retired recording artist. Can you tell us really quickly about that?
Yeah, I've been singing most of my life. If you ladies Google me, you'll find some live videos and maybe some music videos and things like that. I've done everything from rap and R&B to gospel and Christian contemporary music. I sang at the Apollo Theater several times, the Grand Ole Opry, you know, I've done all that good fun stuff. Singer-songwriter, you know, definitely have a gift of songwriting. And I got out of the music biz when I went through a divorce after 16 years with my first husband, because I needed to be there for my kids, which is how I eventually found Pure Romance, because I needed to make some real money and I hated working a job. And I was like, no, I can't keep doing this. And then I found Pure Romance. So yeah, that's pretty much it.
Oh my God, that's so fun. I feel like, do we think that she needs to like sing something for us?
Oh my gosh, at 9 o'clock?
Yeah.
Maybe at the end. Let me get my voice together. And she wants me to sing at 9 o'clock. I can do that. Let me see. Please allow me to introduce myself to you. I'm Angeli, a child of God just like you. And though we may not look the same, God still called my name. Said he had a job for me to do. Made an offer I could not refuse. He anointed me to bring you good news. Brought me out of darkness to help see you through. So would you mind if we had a conversation? Or should I scream? Would it bring more inspiration? Cause I have a lot more rage, but my tone won't stay the same. So I think I'll keep it right here. So every word that I say is clear. If it's all right, if it's okay with you. If not, I'll do what I have to do. Cause I'm just a vessel being used.
Oh my God, that was so good.
Oh my right? God. I have like this whole frog in my throat. Nobody's ever asked me to sing on the training before. That's so funny.
Oh my God. No, I love it. Your voice is so beautiful.
Thank you.
Oh my gosh. Look, I'm so excited. All right. And then her favorite color is red. And look, she's got a red bra for us. Look at that. Mm-hmm. And her favorite food is a pizza. And I asked her how she de-stresses because as business owners, we go through a lot. We carry a lot of stress on our bodies. So I asked her, how does she de-stress herself? And she said through massages, because she is a workaholic, or a workhorse, really. So she works hard all the time. So by having a massage is the only way that she forces herself to do like not do anything, and then also to relieve any stress that she has on her body. All right, so you want to hear all of her stats? So not only is she the mom of five, she also has a book also that she just published. So when we were talking, she was going through book signings. She was also you were recording, like you were reading your book the other day, right? Mm-hmm.
I have a book club, so we were doing a reading for it.
So she has a book out, which I would love for you to briefly talk about also as well. And she's doing all of this with her pure romance business too. So last year she did $111,569 in sales. Her team did just over $1 million. She signed 151 ladies and activated 107. Is anybody else's jaw just dropped really fast? Right? And then so far for the year, her personal sales is 42,000. Her team is over $500,000 already. They're at 606,000. And she already has signed 95 ladies onto her team and activated 43 of them, right? So let's welcome Angelia Robinson. Yay! And I will let you go ahead and take the stage.
Awesome. Thank you for the fanfare. That was so cool. It's like, oh my gosh, I haven't sang in the early mornings. I mean, like I legit just rolled out of bed like 30 minutes ago. That's one thing about me. I'm not at all a morning person. So I really love you girls to get up this early and do this training. Look, I even for Chris's Rise and Grind, I watch it from my bed. Like you never see me on the screen because I'm just like, you know, laying there listening to him or what have you. But it's just, you know, my entertainment background. We worked all night long in the studio writing and performing and stuff like that. And then we slept in, you know, so I keep vampire hours. People don't think I sleep, but I really do. They're like, do you ever sleep? Because I'm like posting or doing stuff all night long. I say I sleep in intervals, right? So I'll go to sleep, but then I'll wake up and I'll do something on my phone and I'll post some things and I'll schedule some things and then maybe I'll go back to sleep. So it's really, maybe that's how I stay so young. I don't know. But anyway, ladies, thank you so much for having me. Team Glistening Divas. Where'd the name come from, Connie? Give me a little background on the name, Glistening Divas.
Let's see. I think it was because I wanted something to where we shine because I love stars and I like shiny things. Mm-hmm. So, but I wanted more than just that because, stars just represent like brightness and fun, and because we're all stars in our own way. Mm-hmm. And we all have something to bring forward. So, and I wanted to use a dynamic word. So then I Googled shiny, you know, things like that. So and then glistening came along. I'm like, oh, I really like glistening, but can I spell it? Like legit, I almost didn't pick it because I was like, can I spell it? So, but I really liked it in the stars. And then my favorite quote is, shoot for the moon. If you miss, you land among the stars. And that's my own personal motto as well, because I've always strived to do better. And you know, if you just happen to fall a little short, you still did better than what you did before. So you should not be ashamed or, you know, feel bad because you didn't hit your goals. So, but you went for it, and that's all that you can do for yourself is just go for it. Because otherwise, how do you know what you're capable of?
I love that. Did all of you know that? Can you put it in the chat? Let me know if you know. Okay, good. So Tiffany didn't know it. Okay, good. It's the reason why I asked it, because I think it's very, very important. I definitely believe in manifesting what you want and who you are, how you want to be and all that. So when you have, there's so much in a name. So the name of your team, you know, having a word that you're going to look to represent that year. Like my word for the year is excel. And damn it, it's only May and I've been doing a lot of shit and I've been really excelling, right? That's my word. I put it out there. So the universe has to make that happen for me as long as I'm putting the work behind it, right? Our team word is execute because they want to do a minimum of 2 million this year. And so we've got a lot of work to do, right? So we just need to execute like all year long. It needs to be about actually putting in the work. So think about those things when it comes to your team name as well and what you want your team to actually represent, how you want them to show up. And you're going to actually draw women to you like that, which I think is very, very powerful. And you'll see that, you'll draw women that have a lot of characteristics like yourself, because your vibe attracts your tribe. I really believe that that is true as well. So just think about that if you guys don't have team names. And I know that some people, even just this past year, with so much that happened with COVID and all the changes and all that, some girls even changed the name of their teams because they just kind of went through certain situations and they wanted to kind of rebrand and revamp and all that kind of stuff. So those are all just great ideas I want you all to think about as your teams are growing. I don't know, do we have like everyone on here, Connie, right? Like your team, all different titles and stuff like that. Okay, perfect. And even if you don't have anyone on your team, even if you have one person on your team, you should have a name. Your team should have a name. I promise you it makes a difference, and have it have a meaning behind it. Okay, so that's your assignment number one. All right, so we just had World Conference, right? So I just, how many of you took my sponsoring class? Were any of you in my sponsoring class? Great, Tiffany was. So what I wanted to do today, because you guys got a lot of great content from myself, from Ashley, and from Rosa, or Lilia, as she prefers to be called. I wanted to get a little bit more personal with you guys today instead of just doing like a straight content training. I'm going to give you some action steps and stuff like that. Don't worry about that. But you did get a lot of great content, but I want to get to the passion of you and your pure romance business as it pertains to sponsoring. So I want to you to ask yourself, what is your passion? And I love what Connie said earlier. She says she has multiple passions. I like that. I've never heard anybody say that like that. Not multiple streams of income, but multiple passions. I love that. Okay, because passion is really important, right? Like when the money is not there, when you're not making the money that you want to make, when you're not recruiting all the girls that you want to recruit and growing the team that you want to grow, if you still have passion, you're going to continue to push forward in your business. Right? So that is extremely important to be able to have passion in anything that you want to do if you want to have sustainability. Okay? So I'm going to put a couple of girls on the spot here. And just because, Tiffany's so lively over there, I'm going to go to her first. So, Tiffany, can you tell me? And it's okay if you don't know, because there was a time in my life when I didn't know. Right? So, is there something you think about? You know what your passion is?
Yeah, I have multiple just as well.
Okay,
I
let's
don't
hear
have
some of them.
just one. I love doing hair. Don't know why. I have no idea. I don't know if it's like the textures of between it or the challenge. But I love doing hair. And then a passion like with pure romance would have to be the connection that you can make with your clients. And that sounds really weird because a lot of people are like, money. I just want your money. Like, I just want your money. I don't care about you. But actually finding how, or maybe not how, but what they need out of our products. Rapid rewind. They got some fine lines or wrinkles that they want to look really good for a picture, or firming cream because of this or that. Like, just finding that connection and then making that my passion. Why do you want this product? It takes 2 seconds to ask the question, and sometimes you end up bawling your eyes out, and it doesn't matter. Just finding that and then being passionate about it. We can talk all day about how we love right now muscle rub. That is my jam. So we can talk all day about why we like it, but why do our clients need it and want it? And then turning that into being your passion. It doesn't take very long. So.
Love it. Love it. No, and Tiffany, you'll go very, very far with that attitude, like not treating people like a number, not just making it about the money. And we all need money to live, right? But just again, being authentic and actually caring about people is going to give you longevity. It's going to breed loyalty with your clients and also with your team members, as we're going to talk about that as well. Very, very important to care about your team and not have them just be, another person that's going to add another zero to your paycheck, right? All right, Jamie, what about you? Can you tell me what your passion is?
I am also a woman of multiple passions. I love anything medieval. How did they live? How did they survive? My daughter is definitely one of my passions. I do all of her Girl Scout stuff with her. I have a band, so I sing all the time. Music is a passion. And when it comes to pure romance, my passion is having that safe space for women who don't have anyone else they can talk to have that place to come and ask questions and know that if I don't have the answer, that's okay, but I will find the answer for them. And I will help them with the things that bother them in one way or another. I just last night was at the bar. We were performing last night and the lady who owned the bar had a horrible migraine. She's like, man, my husband's sick. I'm just stressing out. And I went and got my purse and got my massage melt out of it and rubbed her neck a little bit for her and put it on her temples. And in half an hour, her headache was gone. She's like, I feel great now. And being able to help her feel better. And she's like, by the way, I want to order some of that. You know what I mean? But just helping people find products that make them feel better about themselves. Mm-hmm. And being able to help them find, I mean, if you are happy with you, I'm happy with you. If you got something you don't like, that's okay. We can figure out a way to fix it. Mm-hmm. You know, because I want women to feel empowered and happy with themselves in a way that, unfortunately, so many women don't. And so I want to make that place where every woman feels special.
I love that. So I don't know about you guys, but I could like feel the passion exude from Jamie and Tiffany, right? And so think about how, yep, there you go. Yep, I could hear it too. So you think about that, right? As it pertains to products like they describe, but also as it pertains to their lives changing because of this business, right? And you just never know what somebody's going through, or where they are in their life, and how badly they need you or how badly they need us. And so the same way that those ladies talked about how they want to create the need or find out why this person needs this product, we also have a responsibility to find out why a woman needs this business, why she needs this family, why she needs this sisterhood, right? Why she needs the money, like what's going on in her life, right? Because we all know our whys always change, right? So I'm going to ask two of you ladies that too, right? So let me add, look, I want to be where Bobby's at. She's at the beach. Okay, so let's see. Kelsey, can you talk to me? Can you tell me what your why is?
My why has changed. Went through a pretty big personal change in 2019, beginning of 2020. And I, first of all, I want to say I love the fact that you were like, made it okay for me to realize it was okay for me to change my team name. So my why has drastically changed. It was about the money and saving and doing things for like my family, and I kind of got burnt out, and now it's more about my mental health, and I am very, very passionate, very openly spoken about mental health, and definitely a safe space for women to escape everyday life and come to a party and just be themselves versus mom, chauffeur, cook, made all of that stuff. So I've had a pretty big shift in my why. It went from everybody else to myself.
Love that. And that takes courage. And that's very, very important, right? Because I'm sure most of you have heard that analogy that, you know, like if you're on a plane and God forbid you lose cabin pressure and the oxygen mask drop down, and they say, you know, instinctively, especially, you know, well, women, but especially moms, right? You go into mommy mode and you immediately want to put the oxygen on your kid. But what do they tell you? Put it on yourself first, because, you know, if you're going to help everybody else, you still need to be alive and need to be breathing. Because if you're gone, then you can't help anybody. Everybody dies, right?
So you've got to take care of yourself first. And so I think that is awesome, Kelsey, that you realize that and that you took the position to do that, gave yourself permission to be able to do that. And I think that that's amazing. So check this out. So my mantra is, the more people that you help to become successful, the more successful you will become. So although it is extremely important that we have these goals in mind, I mean, I'm only where I am today because of the amazing training from Pure Romance and learning how to be intentional with my business and setting goals and things like that, right? Absolutely have to do that. And set the goals that are, that, you know, work for you and your vision and where you want to go. But if you have that passion to help others to achieve the things that they want, and Jim Rohn talks about this, you're going to get all the things that you want. So you don't necessarily have to focus on the money. You do have to have a focus and you do have to have your goals set and things like that, that you have in mind. But if you're helping other people to reach their goals, it has to just automatically happen for you if you're being intentional about how you work your business. And so I absolutely, totally am a firm believer in helping others, right? In this business, I mean, all the training and stuff like that that we get, that these women do for free, like I know Connie is always in somebody's group doing a training. We train for Pure Romance, all of that. We don't do it with an expectation to get a paycheck for it. You know, I don't even know when corporate's going to pay us for when we do a training. We don't even care, right? And all of the things that we do for corporate, because of all the things that they do for us, we get it all back. And that's why you see a lot of these top leaders grow the way that they do, because of how they give of themselves selflessly. I can say with all honesty that's so awesome, Jamie. Thanks for shouting out your sponsor. That I've been treated the exact same from top leaders in this company from the day I came into this business until now that people, you know, I'm got a title, you know, and have a $1 million team and stuff like that. I've been treated the exact same. And that says a lot about this sisterhood. And so that is something precious to hold on to and worthy of protecting that culture that we have within Pure Romance, right? Grace, class, and respect. Always remember that. That will take you very far in your sponsoring life as well. All right, so live your life out loud on social media. That is going to be a very awesome way to recruit, to be able to sponsor. It happens organically when you do that. So whatever that looks like for you, right? So like Bobby, perfect thing for her. Like she should be showing everybody on social media. She moved to the beach, right? People, some people have that dream that they want to be able to do that. And they don't even think that it's possible until they see somebody else that looks like them that could do it. You know, like they've been watching Bobby's journey. If they're friends on her Facebook and they're getting to see, you know, what her life was like a year ago, 2 years ago, whatever, if she's showing that journey. I think it's extremely important to be able to do that. Allow people to have a look inside of what your life is like. People are living their lives vicariously through other women until they can see that they can make it happen for themselves. So don't be afraid, you know, and I know some people may have certain restrictions or have to be private about certain things, but if you don't, live it out loud. I mean, just basic stuff. You know, if you don't mind showing your kids, go live with your kids at the beach or at the playground or on vacation at Disney World or whatever, right? And go live in your kitchen cooking. You have a passion for cooking. Jamie, do you go live with your band, you know, with you singing and stuff like that? You know, when you're out, make sure that people are seeing that. Because when you do that, you'll have somebody 6 months down the line, a year down the line, that'll slide into your, I say they slide into your DMs, and they're like, Jamie, I'm ready to do life different. You know, they're like, Kelsey, like, oh my gosh, I've been watching you and I want what you have. Like, you don't think people are watching because they're not commenting? Oh, they're watching. They are watching. And that's also why it's super important to stay, keep everything positive on your social media. You should never, ever be putting any, not even a hint of drama, negativity, anything. If you, you know, you have, I mean, we go through things and we need to talk to people and we need to offload and we need, you know, support and all that kind of stuff. But you got to be careful doing that on social media because people don't really know the whole story. They don't know your backstory. They don't know where you're coming from. You know, everybody knows that texts read kind of crazy. When you post things on Facebook, that reads kind of crazy. All of that is going to affect how you sponsor, how you book parties, you know, all of those things. So live your life out loud on social media. I'm telling you, it is like a hidden gem to being able to sponsor. There's something called drip marketing. I got into this business. I don't know if you guys know this story about me, Connie. I don't even know if you know this, but Dana Barish is my sponsor. And Dana and I have known each other over 20 years. So that's pre-pure romance. She used to be my fitness instructor when I was on tour, like I was doing shows and stuff touring, and she got my body in the best shape it had ever been in my life. Nobody did it before her and nobody did it after her. Like, she was amazing even in that. And so, you know, she had her daughter Tegan. So when she had her first baby, she couldn't come to the gym anymore to work out because Tegan was very colicky. So Tegan wouldn't stop crying unless she ran the vacuum cleaner. That was the only thing that kept Tegan from screaming and crying. So she ended up having to then start training people at her home. And Dana lives far. Like, if you know, like, she lives in Arnold, Maryland. So from where I lived, it was just like I couldn't really afford to make that trip to go train a couple of times a week. So, you know, we still kept in touch over the years. You know, her number never changed. Thank God for that. But one day I was on Instagram and I saw her in a boat on the water. She didn't say anything about pure romance. She didn't say anything about money. She didn't say anything about really, really about business. She touched on it, but she was just like, "Hey, I'm in my mobile office. What are you waiting for? This could be you." And at the time, because everything is about timing and opportunity. So, you know, you may not sponsor that girl this year, maybe not next year, maybe not 5 years down the line, but something's going to happen in her life where she realizes that she needs you. Right. And so you just caught dinner, Bobby. That's so funny. So at the time, you know, I was processing that I had gone through this divorce, that I was working this job that I hated. Okay. So I went from being 12 years entrepreneur into working in someone's office 9 to 5, driving through traffic every day, getting paid pennies while they made millions. I absolutely hated my life. And I'm like, my story can't end like this. I was 42 years old. I've been in business 5 years. I was 42. I'm like, what do I do? What can I find at 42, right? To be able to change my life and make it better. How do I reinvent myself? And so, oh, that's awesome. I love that. So when I saw her on Instagram, I started thinking, I'm like, man, when we worked together, she was a broke fitness instructor and I was a struggling, starving artist. And I'm like, well, and now I'm living paycheck to paycheck. I'm struggling. And she looks like her life is amazing. I went to her Facebook and I started, like I said, people, they stalk your pages. I went and stalked her page and I saw her traveling and I didn't know it was World Conference at the time, but she was on stage and all these beautiful gowns and all this stuff. And I'm like, man, what is she doing? People are watching you like that. What are you doing? And so I called her up. Her number was still the same. I was so excited. And so I'm like, Dana, what are you doing? She's like, Angie, you would be perfect for this. And so we talked and got caught up about our divorces and all that kind of stuff, right? So she sent me to her website. Now, girls, I'm not at all a conservative girl, but the toy world was not my world. So when I went to that website, right, she's like, oh, go to my website. You'll be perfect. Now, mind you, okay, so this dispels the religion or the Christian myth about, you know, people getting into this business. And I had just come out of a Christian music career. So I went to this website and I was like, a whole new world. I was like, what is this stuff? What is that? Like, is that a thing? Oh my God, what do people do with that? And, you know, hindsight is 2020 because that wasn't the first time that I'd gone to her website. The first time she sent me to it when I called her about working out my thighs and trying to tone my thighs several years before. But because I wasn't looking for anything like that at the time, I just went to the website and was just like, oh, I don't know what this is. Oh, that's not for me. And then fast forward like 10 years later, I go to the website because now I'm looking for something. I'm needing something. And all I could think about was, if she can do this, so can I. I don't know what this is, but what do? I was desperate for change. And so Dana just said, buy a kit, get a kit. I didn't even have the money for a kit. So I'm going to tell you, I say this all the time. When girls say that they don't have the money to join, that's not it. It's never about the money. Because I believe that any woman, anything that she wants, she will find a way to get it. We're super women. Like, we're so strong and we can have and do whatever we want. It's just about priorities. She doesn't know how badly she needs this. And if she did, she'd find a way to get it. I borrowed the money from my 16-year-old son who was working at Six Flags and had nothing else to do with his money besides buy tennis shoes. And I was like, son, we're going to be rich. I want to get into this business and I need your help. You know, I need you to buy me this kit. I'm going to pay you back with interest, you know? And so, of course, what's he going to do? Of course, he said yes. That's how I bought my kit. And that's how I came into the business. And Dana didn't say anything, you know, about making a bunch of money or anything. She was just on Instagram in a boat on the water in her backyard, you know, right? Because she lives on the water. I'm in my mobile office. What are you waiting for? This could be you, right? Live your life out loud on social media. All right, so here's your first action step. Have you girls ever done like a social media challenge? Have you guys been challenged to do that before? Ooh, that's your first step. You took your kids' Christmas money from grandparents' bucket. Yes, see, we will do whatever we gotta do, Bobby. We will make it happen, okay? We will make it happen and figure the rest out later. So keep that in mind when you're talking to a girl. Why do you think that so many women are joining this business for the $39 and for the $19.99, right? Because they just were afraid to invest their money in something that they were unsure of. They didn't either believe in themselves or they didn't believe in the company or the product. They just are unsure. And so they just didn't want to take that money and spend it on something like this. Okay, so keep that in mind. Okay, so yes, you did a 30-day live. Okay, so I want everyone to do, and it's perfect because we're at the beginning of the month. You can start today, and every day, I want you girls to go live on your Facebook pages, on your Instagram pages, wherever your main social media challenge is. And if you have no restrictions, I want you to do it publicly and not privately in your VIP groups, okay? So if you have no issues with being public on Facebook, every day, and I want you to be intentional. So it's not going live about your pure romance business. You can, like, out of, you know, a few of those days out of the month, but I want you to pick a topic about something that you're going to go live about. And it can be dumb shit. You know, like it can be life hacks. You know, like I learned how to pull the tendon out of a chicken tenderloin and I taught everybody else on Facebook how to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like this is just, what it's going to do is going to boost your algorithms, number one. It's going to make you visible and memorable to people, seeing your face every single day. I hope my girls hate you as much as they hated me when I had them to do. I love it. I love to challenge them. I love to get people out of their comfort zone because there's so much joy in seeing what it does for them. And then they're super excited when they see, when they reap the rewards of them actually doing it. Okay. Now, if you're somebody that hates going live or you're nervous to talk to people and all that kind of stuff, listen, be creative. Get people in your live with you, right? That can help, you know, to kind of camouflage your nervousness or what you want to do. So, Jamie, you can go live with your band, you know, like do something like interview somebody from your band, you know, find out, you know, why they're into music, how long have they been singing, find out, you know, all the different things, right? Okay. And any other hobbies and things like that, Tiffany, go live doing somebody's hair. You know what I'm saying? Like it doesn't have to be pure romance, but what you want is for people to fall in love with you. You guys hear Chris say it all the time. People don't buy product. They buy you. People don't join this business because of the product, right? They may get into this business because they want money, but they're really buying what they see in you. And what your life is like, or what they saw in you at a party, right? So that's your first assignment is that, well, second, because I gave you one earlier too, but that's your second assignment is to go live every day for the month of May, okay? And start to build those connections and those relationships with people. Make sure that you're interacting with them. So when you're going live, you wanna make sure that they comment. So you can say, of course, we've got the whole, if you're watching live, drop one, drop two if you're watching the replay. Or you can say, listen, I wanna know where you're watching from, right? Get them to talk to you. Get them to engage with you. And then when you need to book a party, and then when there's a kit sale that's coming around, you're looking to sponsor, like you won't be a stranger to these people. Like if you haven't talked to them in a year, you're a stranger, right? But if they're seeing you regularly on Facebook, you know, just sharing a glimpse into your life, they're going to eventually want to be a part of that life. Because I feel like women join this business for like five different reasons, right? These are the reasons that I generally say, right? They want to join to make money. They also want to belong to something that helps to validate them. all women want to, I mean, people in general want to feel validated, right? But we're talking about women. They want to be loved. They want to be validated. They want to feel like they belong to something, right? All of that. So those, that's another reason why they join. They also join because they want to be like you. And I know that sounds kind of like stalkerish, right? But they're watching you and they want your life as they see your life is begin, as they see your glow up, I like to call it, like not your grow up, but your glow up. As they start to see your life change, I have people that have joined my team because they've watched me from the beginning and then they see where I am now. Like, girl, I've been watching you. I need that. I want that. Right? So that's another reason. They want to be like you. And don't worry, right? They're going to eventually come into their own where they start to grow and learn and change and become their own authentic self. But from the outside looking in at first, they're like, I want that life. I want that life that I see that she has with these girls in this pure. I want to play in the sandbox with them. Okay. All right. Also, they want to just be with you. If you're a positive person and you're exuding positivity. Right. Okay, Connie. Yes. I'm just seeing your comment. Yes. Not in your groups, your personal. Yeah. Personal Facebook. So yeah, they want to be with you. They want to hang out with you. When they see us at World Conference and national training and they say, listen, wait till we get back to getting together. Like that in and of itself helps us to sponsor. Just seeing us all together. There's nobody like us. There's nobody like us. And so that's another thing that makes it a lot easier to be able to sponsor because people are looking for stuff like that. I've been an entrepreneur most of my life, and I've not ever been a part of an organization like this organization. I want to know who has a better plan B. Okay. Also, they have a hope for a better quality of life. People are going through shit. They've always gone through shit. But the time that we're living in right now is just super, super crazy. And people are looking for an answer. When I got into this business, I was looking for an answer. I was looking for something different. What can I do? What could I do? People, they get to a certain age and they feel like, you know, it's too late for them to do anything. And I tell people all the time, it's never too late to be who or what you might have been. Never too late. I don't care how old you are. I don't care what you've been through. I don't care the things that you've done. I don't know if you've seen the background of some of these ladies. Like, we have women in this business, top leaders that were born into drug families, that were crack babies, that were in jail, like did all types of stuff. And they were able to turn their lives around and now are leading multi-million dollar teams. I pour my life into my autobiography, my book that Connie was talking about, and you get to read and see all of the crazy things that I did in my life. And you're always able to turn it around. Never let people define you and what it is that you can do. And there's another woman out there that needs you to tell her the same thing. People need us. We are a necessity, right? So you've got to believe that about yourself, and then other people will feel that your energy is everything, everything. Your energy is everything. Remember that. You've got to remember that about being positive. Okay, who has a money train group in here? Does anybody in here have a leads group? Okay, Connie has one. Okay, so now I didn't discuss this with Connie, so hopefully I'm not overstepping when I say this. But our team has a team money train group, and it's been something that even Pure Romance Corporate has had me talking about in my trainings because it really, really works. And I'll tell you why it works. So I don't know if this is something that you guys will consider doing, even if it's not with Connie, but you can even do it within your own respective teams. The reason why it works is because all of the women that we talk to, they may not necessarily identify with who we are and where we are in our lives right now, right? So you might be talking to the college student that has, if I talk to the college student that has a whole lot of debt, I don't have a whole lot of debt and I didn't go to college. So when I'm talking to her about why this business is amazing and how it can help her and all of that, she might not really readily identify with me and feel like this business can do something for her. Like, oh, she's old. She's 48 and got 5 kids. I don't have any kids. I'm just out here trying to live my best life. So I don't need that business. I can't see what it's going to do for me. Right. But if you have people in a space, they're contained in a space with all these different personalities and different walks of life, you know, sexual orientation, religion, all of that kind of stuff. They may not identify with me and they haven't said yes to the business yet because they don't resonate with my story. But what if they heard a story from somebody else on my team that they can resonate with? And that makes them say, oh, she's doing this. Like, oh my gosh, oh, I see myself in her. I can do this too. So what we do in our Money Train group, and we don't have, like, I have 365 women, I think, on my team. And we probably only have about 50 girls in the Money Train group. And I can tell you that it is because of that Money Train group that our team exploded last year. We just implemented that Money Train group in January of last year. And I know that that single-handedly caused our team to skyrocket. And it also bred a sponsoring culture within the team. It's like expected. It's what you do. We need to share the opportunity with women. And so we're in this group. So we have two groups. One of them is an admin group. And so that's going to be just with all the consultants. And this is where we correspond and discuss what the plan is going to be for the month. And we also have a chat for it as well, because we know Facebook's tripping and it won't let us see stuff, right? So we have a chat so that we can communicate directly with one another. Then we also have the Money Train group, which we call the Future Millionaire group, which is where all of our leads go. And so there's a consultant that is scheduled every day to be the zebra of the day, right? So my team is called the Zealous Zebras. So they're the zebra of the day. And it's not a lot on them. It's just, we ask that they just post three times a day, anything inspirational that you want to share. So they have an introductory post that they'll schedule, because you know, you can schedule your posts in your groups. They'll schedule it, you know, in the morning, and it'll be like, you know, hey, this is Angelia Robinson. I'm your zebra of the day, you know, and I got into this business because of whatever. And they'll just share whatever inspiring story that they want to share about their life, or even a story about another consultant. Because see, everybody doesn't have a success story yet. That's okay. You just share somebody else's story. I did it. I shared Dana's story, Angela DeDona's story. I shared all their stories before I had my own success story, right? And that's totally fine. And so every day you have these, I call it the diamond effect. So when you have everybody contained in this one space, and you have some girls that are really considering the business, you have some that just got in there because there might be some free giveaways. You know, you have some in there that are just being nosy and want to know what it is that you're talking about. Some are in there because you asked and they didn't want to tell you no, right? You've got all of those people kind of mixed in that group. But you have the pressure of the healthy pressure of the consultants that are just putting all of this positive energy into this group, posting all of these positive quotes, posting these videos about how their life can be this and that, posting, you know, the rock star report, you know, posting, you know, we pull stories from everywhere that we see different consultants may share, things that corporate shares on the training site, different things. They're being saturated with what their future can be like on a daily basis. They got all this other crap that they see on Facebook. And then this is the one group that they can just see nothing but positivity every day, that they just see something inspiring. And you'll catch them on a day where somebody pissed them off at work. You'll catch them on a day that they, you know, discover that, oh my God, my relationship is ending. You'll catch them on a day when they're in postpartum, you know, depression. You'll catch them on a day where they're like, I need this. And then there'll be a special that's running, a $39 special, a $19.99 special, where they'll say, you know what, I want to give this a try, right? And so they've got all of these different personalities that I really think, so we're essentially helping to sponsor for each other, right? And there is we do kit giveaways, right? Which I totally didn't believe in before, because I'm like, I'm not giving anybody a kit for free. They're not going to really do anything with it if you give it to them for free. Right. But you know what? That's not really my business. If I'm giving from my heart, what they do with it is on them. I give them the opportunity, and if they squander it, that's on them. I'm still going to get the blessing. I'm still going to reap the rewards for me giving from my heart. Right. So every quarter we pay $15. So that's $60 a year to go towards that kit giveaway. Okay. So everybody in the group, $15, as many of those thank God for the social sellers. As many of those social sellers that we can give away with the money that we've taken in, we do that also in the interim within those quarters. So once a quarter, we do a scholarship giveaway, which consists of this. We have a Google form that has a questionnaire, you know, like, why do you want to get into this business? Tell me about your family life. You know, what do you do for a living? Do you want to do this part-time? You know, do you want to do this full-time? We ask all of these questions. And then we take a vote blindly, right? So the Google Doc is pulled with no names. So the names are removed. And we just read the stories of the people that are submitting for the scholarship. So this scholarship is actually for a kit that comes with products. So it's for a standard kit. Generally, we just do a standard, right? And so we vote on it. That person wins the scholarship. They've got a free business, right? But since the $39 social seller came into play, because we take in so much money every quarter, and then ladies give more money. We're like, okay, whatever you wanna give, it's not mandatory that they give anything outside of the $15 a quarter, but what we've done is created a culture for wanting to give. And let me tell you the magic that happens. So what happens is it's either surrounding an EOO that we're doing with the Diamond Empire, okay, which is my upline, Dana Bearish, we'll call the Diamond Empire, or it's surrounding the Synergy of Seven, which I don't know if you guys have heard about that we do with Mia Rivera and, you know, some of six other top leaders, right? So that's like one big EOO with these seven top leaders. Do you guys do EOOs, right, Connie? I know you guys do EOOs, right? Okay. So there's a reason for the EOO that's coupled with the giveaway of the kit, because they have to have some skin in the game. Like, we're not going to just give away a kit. Like, you have to at least dedicate an hour of your time to listen to why this business is amazing so that they can see that they should do something with this kit should they win it. Okay. So they have to actually be a part of the EOO, and then we give a code word, right? So that when we do this giveaway, if they don't have the code word and we pull their name, they forfeit. Because if you couldn't even dedicate the time to watch us talk to you about this business, we're not going to give you a kit. Okay. So that's very important to know. We're not going to just give it to you and you did nothing and you paid. We don't do that, right? So what happens is inside of that Money Train group on the day that we're doing the giveaway, I'll go live and get everybody excited. We've got, you know, oh my gosh, you know, we're going to be giving away 15 businesses today. You know, if it's the social seller, if it's the one, you know, scholarship, we're going to give this away. And so we actually pull the winners live. And I call them live. This is like an Oprah moment, right? And so we call them live and I'm like, hi, Tiffany, do you know who this is? And she's like, yes. You know, she's been watching. Yes, it's Angelia, Senior Executive Director with Pure Romance. And girl, do you have a code for me? And she's like, yes, it's empowerment, you know, whatever. And it's like, yes, you got a business. So everybody's watching this. Consultants, leads are watching, and you know, let us know who your sponsor is. Oh, it's Trudy. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Can't wait to meet you. This is so amazing. Congratulations, right? So we're live and we give the ladies the opportunity also to pay it forward. So a lady will come on and we'll tell her she's a winner and we'll say, you can either pay it forward or you can accept the offer. I want to pay it forward. So she'll pay for her own business, and then gift the one that she was winning to someone else. It is the most magical thing. Like, this thing like took on a life of its own. We had no idea that that was going to happen. So women were inspired by the EOO that happened before, that they want to be a part of this. And now the money they said they didn't have, they now just miraculously have, okay? They're buying their own business and then they're paying it forward to somebody else. And then we're like, okay, well, this is our last one. Like, oh my gosh, we wish we could just give away two more businesses. And then somebody will comment, I'll donate money so that we can give away another business. Consultants and leads. It is the craziest thing. It is the most empowering thing. And so whether someone is winning, offering money, joining on their own or not, they get to see who we are in that group. They're watching and they're like, oh my God, this is amazing. I can't believe these women love each other like this. I can't believe these women support each other like this. And it's contagious and they want to be a part of that. So like I said, even if they're just watching on the sidelines, oh, they're coming eventually. We bottomed out of that daggone, you know, money train group several times, and you got to get new leads in there all the time because they will eventually drop out of that funnel. So that's the magic of the money train. So I'll leave that up to you guys to talk to your sponsor about that. If that's something that she decides to do, she's going to need your help, and she's not going to be able to do it by herself, or she's not going to want to do it by herself, right? So that's going to be a commitment that you guys have. And watch, if you really want to build a team, if you guys work together, team, together, everyone achieves more. Okay, you got that? Team, together, everyone achieves more. And I'm going to tell you, transparent moment. I've always heard about the money train, but I also heard that I heard about it from a consultant named Abigail Mosqueda. I don't know if you guys have heard of her, but she actually talked to my team about it maybe 2 years into the business. And, you know, some people, not on my team, but I've heard other people, you know, like they were fearful of having this money train group because they didn't want anybody to take their leads. That's not who we are. I don't know the teams that are like that. That's not who we are. I don't think that's who you are. We've never had that issue, and I'm not concerned about having that issue. And if something like that does happen, karma, karma's real. I wouldn't worry about that. But you can do so much more working together. Okay. All right. Action step three, manifest. You know what I do? When I get a lead, I put them in my phone as them already being a girl on my team. So whatever you, however you have them listed in your phone, me, I call them my PR daughters. So if I get a lead, I put them in my phone as my PR daughter. That's who they are. I'm manifesting that. I'm saying that, you know, by putting that in my phone that way. And so eventually I see that happening. I like that. So yeah, Connie says together we shine. It's true. Right. So I put them in my phone as my PR daughter, and I work really, really hard around the kit sale, which is what I'm going to get to as well. So you want to prep for the kit sale days before. And I'm not telling you to only, you know, to only work this when there's a kit sale. But I know that a lot of us have a lot of different things going on. Like you all have a lot of different passions going on. I'm sure I have some moms on here. We have a lot going on, and it really takes a lot to be able to excel in both sales and sponsoring. It's usually like this, right? I mean, unless you're Lilia Martinez, because that girl is freaking killing it. Oh my God, what? Okay, she's got sales and she's got sponsoring, but usually you see that somebody is doing better in one area than they are the other. It's really kind of hard to juggle the both of them and have you shine in both areas, okay? So the way that I actually do it is that, you know, I actually take time to focus on just sponsoring. Like when the kit sale comes around, that is my, that's like the button that I push to say, okay, Angie, shift to sponsoring mode. Right. So the rest of my sponsoring is happening organically. It's happening by me living my life out loud on social media. It's happening by me always playing a sponsoring game at my parties. Girls, if you're not doing a sponsoring something at your parties, you're doing yourself such a disservice. Whether you're doing virtual parties or you're doing in-home, you have to do some type of sponsoring game. And whatever that looks like for you, like I've been doing the same sponsoring game for at least 3 years, maybe four. I will ride something until the wheels fall off. I'm like, if it ain't broke, don't fix it. There's so many things that you see all of the girls do. I mean, you girls are geniuses. In this business, there's so many genius women. It's ridiculous. So you see all the things that they're doing, and you're like, ooh, I'm going to try that. Ooh, okay, I'm going to do that. Ooh. You're never going to get any momentum if you do that. Get something, one thing, and try that thing, work that thing, see if it's your niche, see if it's going to work for you. And if you've done that consistently and it doesn't work for you, then try something else. But don't do them, because you're never going to find the momentum in that one area to see what works for you. So the sponsoring game that I do the romance game. I don't even know if it's still on, because we've changed so much on the training site, but it's the sheet that spells out the word romance. And then it tells you what that letter stands for, right? And so it's like, I play this game and I'm like, okay, ladies, whoever yells out the nastiest, raunchiest, dirtiest word you can think of that starts with the letter R, you know, starts with the letter, is going to get a point, right? So if I'm doing a virtual party, they get a point. If I'm doing an in-home party, they're getting a ticket or something like that, right? And then, you know, like the first word R stands for rewards. You know, our consultants, you know, are rewarded with, you know, free product and discounts or whatever. And consultants are rewarded with cash and trips and free product and much, much more. So it gives me an opportunity to expound. It's my Pure Romance, you know, my sponsoring commercial. It gives me a chance to expound on what it is that we do and why this business is amazing in the middle of a game, so people don't feel like they're being sold to. People don't feel like, you know, I'm selling the business to them. We're playing a game. They want more tickets. They want more points because they have an opportunity to win something free. So they'll ask all the questions. So I'll go through that and then I'll say, okay, so I need three more questions that maybe this sheet doesn't answer for you. So think like this. If you were thinking about doing this business, right? Or maybe you know someone, maybe it's not you, but maybe you know someone that you're like, oh, wow, I think so-and-so would be really good at this. What questions would you need the answer to before you decided to give it a try? And then, of course, they ask the golden questions. So how much is the cost to get started? You know, how much money do you make? How many parties do you do? They'll ask all the questions and I'll give them all the answers. And I even started, you know, Connie, I started, and I think that I originally got this idea from Sly, but because at Sly's parties, she used to like show her her override checks. And so during my sponsoring game on virtual, I don't do it in home, but virtual I do. I'll show my bonus check. And I'm just like, listen, I got receipts. I'm not trying to blow smoke up your wazoo. I'm just going to show you, check this out. And I'll put it in the screen like, oh my God, you made that? Yes. And this is peanuts in comparison to what you could earn, because women that have been in this business longer than me, you know, or those that are just anomalies that come in here and just kick ass, you know, the potential is there. And I, of course, I'll tell them, now there are levels to this, right? There are some that, you know, maybe their bonus check is only $100, or maybe it's, you know, $1,000, or maybe it's $20,000. But the potential is there if you work the business. And I sponsor like crazy during my parties with doing this. Because people need to see. I remember Chris told us this. I was in his 2016 Future Leader class. And what he was teaching us is that, look, people don't want handouts anymore. Like, they don't need more material to be able to read about this and read about that. They need you to show them what can happen for them. That's why those pure success stories are really, really important to show. Share them in your VIP groups. Share them in your money train groups. Let them see that there are women just like them, that their life can change just like this person's life changed, because they were once here and now they're here. They need to be able to see that. There's so many scams out there, you know, that people, they don't know who to trust. They don't know what's going to work or what's not going to work. You need to show them, you know, like, you know, what is that movie? Something McGuire, right? Show me the money, right? Like, you got to, you know, you got to show them. We can't just tell them, because people have been telling people bullshit for years. They need to see that it's really real. And fortunately, we're a part of an organization where it's really real. We're really making money. And I mean, there's like 10%, less than 10% of the world that makes six figures. You know how many women in this business make six figures? I never made six figures my whole life, not even in the music biz. Never made six figures till Pure Romance. Okay. All right. okay. So when I said prep for the kit sale, I manifest sometimes by taking those PRCEF forms that we don't really have a use for anymore. I use them to manifest. So I will write, I'll have my leads list of people that I'm going to follow up with about the business, and I'll write their names on the PRCEF forms, and I'll hang them up in my office. I'll hang them up in my office, and then as each girl joins, I'll pull it down, joined, broop, joined, right? So I just send some of the same scripts again and again, like no point in beating around the bush, but you know, when it comes time around, hey girly, well, I never say hey girl, I always say the name, right? Okay, so hey Trudy, are you still thinking about doing what I do? Have you thought more about doing what I do? Hey, Trudy, how's it going, girly? You know, if you've had a conversation with them, if you've been talking to them, you know, about their life, if you're kind of in their life, and that's why it's important to be on your social media to kind of see what people are going through, right? Did somebody just lose their job and they're talking about it? Did somebody just have a birthday? You know, is somebody going through a divorce? You know, like what's happening in their life that you can kind of like speak to them in regards to that, or kind of know when it's time to go, when the green light or when there's a red light. That red light would be maybe they just, somebody died in their family. Oh, You don't want to reach out to them about joining the business. You don't want to reach out to them about booking a party, right? So it's important to kind of know some of those different nuances. Connie and Bobby's monthly recognition is huge. Ooh, awesome. I love to hear that. Okay, so I spend a lot of time on purpose when those kit sales happen in my phone. Like sometimes for hours, I can get stuck in my phone, messaging people, putting it out there, messaging people. So you do have to, it's a lot of work if you want to mass sponsor. You have to put the time in and just block that time off. I realize that everybody may not have the time that I have, but you could say like, okay, today I'm spending 30 minutes and I'm just going to message girls, you know, about the kit sale that's coming up. Sometimes offer incentives for them to be able to do it. You know, I did this amazing thing that I learned from Leanne as well. Leanne is so amazing. And like twice a year, she does like this, you know, like Christmas in July type of thing or what have you with sponsoring. So she'll get all these gifts and you can, you know, get stuff from like Ross or TJ Maxx, you know, like inexpensive designer, like little handbags or, you know, wristlets or, you know, whatever free product. You can make up whatever it is you want to do. Ross has really great Michael Kors bracelets that are cost you like $20, $30, stuff like that. Stuff that people wouldn't spend their own money on, but they love to win it for free. And then she would wrap them in gifts. And she would take a picture and she would post it. And I can put all of this in your group, Connie, if you want me to share, if it's something that they want to do. And you would tell people, you're like, hey, you know, and I can't think of the wording right now, but I have it all. But you take a picture of this and you post it and say, you know, hey, you know, if you could win, you know, anything, if you could win a Michael Kors bracelet, if you could win, you know, a Michael Kors purse, if you could win this, if you could win cash, what would you pick? And then people will comment, I'll take the Bessie Johnson bag, or I'll take the cash, or I'll take this, I'll take that, right? So it's like a slow build to that. And then you tell people to pick a number, and they have an opportunity to be able to win one of these gifts. And then there's like a whole little script or dialogue that you private message them to tell them how to get the gift. And how they get the gift, first they join your team and they get to pick this gift, and they only get the gift once they activate. Yes, okay, you do it a couple times, yep. Pay it forward, I believe it's what, yep. And it really worked. Oh my God, I like sponsor like 30 people, you know, 30 and 40 people a month when I've done that. So it really, really, really works. People just, they like free stuff. And like I said, they'll say that they don't have the money, but then you dangle a carrot about a free gift and all of a sudden they have the money to get a kit just so they can get the free thing that they could really take that money and buy the free thing. You see like how that works? Okay, it is what it is. All right, let's see, I think I'm almost done. Oh, yep, last thing. Your reason for sponsoring, and I think I touched on this earlier, needs to be bigger than the money or the status quo. So I think that like Kelsey was touching on that, where at first it was just about the money for her and then now it's different. So your reason for sponsoring needs to be bigger than the status quo and bigger than the money, because people can sense when you're not being authentic, when you're just putting on a show, just putting on a front, and it's really not about them for you, it's just all about you. And I think Ashley Cohen talked about that as well on her training during World Conference. You know, is that, you know, she doesn't sponsor and make it like, you can't make it about, oh, I need the one more girl to level up. Oh, I need one more whatever so I can get my bonus. Like when you're sponsoring in desperation like that, it doesn't really work out that well. Not on a consistent basis. Right? You always want to be in sponsoring mode. Everywhere that you go, be listening for the opportunity to share with somebody. So when you go out to eat, the waitress, she's always a lead. The waitress is a lead. She's busting her ass in there, busting tables and waiting and carrying stuff, and she's not making a whole lot of money. She could easily do what we do. She's always a lead. You know, listen to people when you hear them talk about, oh my gosh, I just hate my job so much, you know, whatever. I just can't, you know, all those people. Oh my gosh, I don't have any friends. It's just, I just need something. I need to join some type of organization, whatever. Always be listening for those key words, you know, for you. It's when you're in like Dollar Tree or something like that, you see the girl every time you go in Dollar Tree, she's always at work and she's always working hard. Like, girl, you are always at work. Do you ever get a break? Girl, you need some fun in your life. You need like, I mean, gosh, you need a girl's night, or you just need like, oh my gosh, have you ever heard of Pure Romance? You know, no, oh girl, we're the in-home party company for women, you know, and now we do things virtually, whatever, we have the best in bath and beauty and things that buzz in the night. Like, girl, you listen, you could totally do this as well. Is this all that you do for a living? Is this your full time? You know, like, ask those questions, be on all the time. Because what do we say? What's the reasons why people don't book parties? Because nobody asked them. What is the reason why people haven't joined our business? Because nobody asked them. I can't tell you how many women that I have sponsored onto our team that were, they've been doing parties for 10 years. They've been somebody's client for 10 years. And that consultant never asked them about joining the business. It blows my mind every single time. Like, what? Like, yeah, girl, nobody asked me, you know? And then they're so indebted to you. They're like, I'm glad she didn't ask me, you know, because I'm, you know, I really want to be on your team, because nobody ever asked them. So don't be the consultant that didn't sign a Jen Kelly, that didn't sign a Connie Moritz, that didn't sign a Dana Barris just because you didn't ask her. You'll be kicking yourself 10 years down the line, like, oh my God, that was my client. And she's a Dana Barris just because you didn't ask her. So make sure you ask. All right, that's all I got. Any questions? Like, open for questions. I guess we got a little bit of time for questions. Hopefully that was helpful.
That was great. I have like a page and a half of notes.
Oh, really? Good. Kelsey said, no, it's over too soon.
Well, does anybody have anything that you would like Angeli to touch on?
Can you repeat what you said for team? Like, team stands for its team, everyone, whatever. I didn't get all of that.
Yep. Together, everyone achieves more.
I love that, by the way.
Yep.
That's it's awesome.
True. Thank you. It's so true. You're welcome, Leanna. That's such a pretty name. Okay, copy the sponsoring game. Okay, sure. Yep. I'll take a picture and post it, because I don't even know where you can get it anymore. I've been using it forever.
I do have one question. I took your class back. It was like the beginning of the year when we had our training.
Mm-hmm.
You had the leaders list and money train group.
Mm-hmm.
Do you think you could post that?
You said the leaders list. Are you talking about?
Yeah, the leaders list and yeah.
Are you talking about my lifestyle earners program?
Maybe that's what it was. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I was trying to write everything fast during that time. So.
Okay. Yep. No problem. And I'm trying to think the best way to do it. Maybe I can email it to you, Connie, if you want to share it with everybody. Just like give me your email. So what she's what I think she's asking about, I have a program. It's kind of like a baby version of Chris's Future Leader program. So it really kind of preps girls to be tapped for that. I think it's very important to identify girls on your team that want more and that are looking to be built up as leaders, to be trained as leaders. And so I make it a really like big deal, right? So they get a golden ticket, like in Willy Wonka, you know, watchers here, right? So, you know, and the qualifications are really, really basic. So it's like they need to at least be doing $500 in retail sales consistently, right? A month. That's not a lot at all. So $500 a month in retail sales consistently. They need to have sponsored at least one person within the 3 month period that I'm watching them. And then they also have to be active amongst the team, right? Because again, I'm looking for leaders, for potential leaders. So I want to see girls that are, you know, active in the team page, that are helping other girls, that are posting things, you know, all of that. So I'm taking those few things and then bringing them into this program. So I mail them out like this golden ticket, and they get like a little gift and everything that comes with it. And then I welcome them into this team. It's up to them. They don't have to be a part of it, but it's a really big deal. Like, girls really work towards wanting to be a part of this Elite Lifestyle Earners program. So it's a coaching program. So I coach them. I used to do it quarterly, and then, you know, then I just broke it up into twice a year. So I do it twice a year now. And so every 2 weeks, I have a program that I actually get on Zoom with them. And we 2 hours, we're working together. I'm working with them, you know, talking with them individually. They all get accountability partners so that they're working together. And I give them tasks to do every 2 weeks. And that really helps them to build on their business. Because sometimes that's all that people really need. I don't even really think it's like a special program, but they just need somebody that takes the time out with them to give them the steps to be able to be successful in their business. Everybody's not a self-starter. Everybody's not self-motivated. And some people need to kind of be given those action steps and to be held accountable. Like they have homework assignments and every 2 weeks they've got to report back and let me know what they've done. And to see how they've grown throughout that process and you develop these leaders, it's amazing. I mean, it's like, I mean, I hit the top level in the company, what, like in three years, and I have 17 senior consultants and above on my first line. And I know there have been women in this business like 15, 20 years that didn't have 10 to be able to reach that top level. And I really think it is has a lot to do with that program, just being able to work with people like that.
Yeah, that was the program. Thank you so much.
You're welcome, hon. Anybody else? Well, hopefully that means that I covered a lot. You guys got a lot.
Absolutely. So this was absolutely amazing. Thank you so much for taking the time to do this.
You're so welcome. It's always my honor to be able to speak. You know, I really look at it as an honor and a privilege to be able to speak into somebody's life. It's very, very important. I appreciate you trusting me, Connie, to be able to do that.
And I can't wait to see you again. It has been forever.
I know. You're going to be on the board trip, right?
No. So I have my grandbaby is due June 23rd.
Girl, you are a G-Ma. Get out of here.
So, which is the week of the board trip. So I'm not. So I don't know. Like, it's still too early to know if she's going to be induced or whatnot. But her due date is that week. Mm-hmm. So I'm just not going to take the chance to miss it. So
That's so sweet. Okay, so the national training.
Yes. Yeah.
Okay. I'll be there, for sure. Are you girls signed up for national training?
Yes. Yeah, so excited. So excited.
I encourage you that if you can make it happen, like if you don't have, like, you know, if you're not delivering a baby on that day or something like that, like if it's about money, I need you to find a way to get there. I mean, there's still some slots left, and I've never missed a training. And I promise you, I'm 48. I've never, ever had the success in my life like since I've been a part of this business. If you don't live, eat, sleep, and breathe the words of Chris Ciccanelli and then all of these top leaders that he's been coaching along the way, that is the reason why I am where I am today, is because of women like Connie that have poured into us, that have come before me. And going to those trainings is priceless. It really, really is. You have to stay around the fire. I say that we are the oxygen to each other's businesses. We need to stay connected. If you disconnect, I tell you right now, you're not going to survive this business if you disconnect. You have to stay connected. Stay connected. Attend all the trainings. I don't care if you hear the same thing over and over again. You're always going to get another nugget that you can use and apply in your business. It's going to be a game changer for you.
National training definitely changed my business that was my first year in, for only being in a couple of months, that it's amazing. Training, everything that we get from corporate and from the leaders, it's just amazing. I cannot thank Connie and Bobby mostly for helping me so much. Like, Connie helped me make an FU club. And I just changed my president's club motto to an FU club. So for everybody who told me that you can't amount to anything, it's just another, like, told you so, like, screw you. I'm still doing it.
Yep. I love it. I love it. I'm telling you, it's, and yes, definitely, as she said it, my first year in, so like I joined at the end of October 2015, and I went to World Conference, And at, during that time, I had also been selected to be in Chris's Future Leader Program. And so when I heard about national training, I totally had no intentions of going. I was just like, well, I just went to World Conference. Like, why would I go to national training? It's probably going to be the same content. Like, I don't need to do that. But it was part of the program. It was mandatory that you attended national training also. If it were not for that, I probably would not have gone. So I'm so thankful that that was part of the criteria, is that you had to attend national training in order to be able to meet, you know, like, I'm very competitive. I'm like, oh, I'm not going to not, you know, graduate this program, you know, because I don't go to a training. And so I went, and I'm gonna tell you, it just was a game changer. You know, World Conference, number one. I mean, I caught the bug real bad after World Conference. Just to see all those amazing women walk that stage, to see all that they had accomplished, to see all of the glitz and the glam and all the gifts that they received. And it was just like, oh my God, like, I didn't know this was a real business until I went to World Conference. Like, this is real, people are really making money. And so again, it's again about showing, right? It's about showing and not telling. And so when you attend those types of events, you get to see that it's real. You get to see regular women just like you and I that have been able to achieve amazing things. And you're able to see that they're no better than you, that they're no different than you. All they did, they put their nose to the grind, because it is a hustle. You need to work hard. And I mean, like, nothing that's worth having is going to come easy anyway. But, you know, what we do, I feel, is easy. It's just operating a business that's hard, right? That's any business. I don't care what it is. It takes a lot of work if you want to be successful at it. And you kind of have to even almost be obsessive, like, within working that business to get it to grow. But if you do it, like, this is the one business you can count on that if you do, you're going to get. If you do, you're going to get the rewards and what we get. Like, nobody has what we have.
Amen.
I just want to say thank you again for doing this regional. I know a lot of us have been missing having that in person, and just to have another regional, even if it's virtual, I mean, it means a lot to me because I learned so much from them, and I know a lot of the other girls do too. So thank you so much for taking your time and doing this with us.
You are so welcome. You're so welcome.
So thank you so much. And thanks for waking up early for this.
You're so welcome. You're so welcome. Oh, you know what? Hey, John. Do me a favor, babe. Can you look on the table in the front and bring me one of those books with my face on it? In the front, in the hallway. Go down the hallway. My son's best friend is over here. He's got to direct him. I remember Connie mentioned. Go ahead.
As I was like, it's okay. It's like, I had, my son had prom yesterday. So him and his girlfriend and my unborn grandchild is upstairs sleeping. So that's why I came downstairs with my AirPods, so that way I didn't have to wake him up. So they had prom last night, and they didn't come home till like 2:30 in the morning, so I didn't want to wake them.
Oh, wow. Okay. But this is my book. So Connie mentioned saying something about my book. Mm-hmm. It's called Who Are You? Tales of a Survivor. And so that's my other passion, is really helping women that are survivors of sex abuse. I am also a survivor. And, you know, April was Sexual Assault Awareness Month. So I just kind of, in my book, it's my autobiography. So I just share everything about my life. And it's just a story of trauma to triumph. And so that is, you know, kind of like it's taken on a life of its own. So like Connie said, you know, you can have multiple passions. And in fact, Chris, he even encourages that we have multiple passions, and you can use pure romance as a catalyst to get to whatever those other passions are. So you use the money that you earn from your team, from your parties, you know, from your outside sales to fund all of the other things that you want to do in life. You can do, that was a dream of mine to write that book, and I was able to do it and pay for it in cash. Like, I don't owe anybody. That was like a $20,000 project, you know? And then I go into the studio this month and do the Audible. Like, I don't know if I could have done that, you know, on it with a 9-to-5, like, oh my gosh. So, and you know, and listen, I know there's some people that really love their jobs, that love their 9-to-5. So I'm not knocking the 9-to-5. That's just not me. I can't work for anybody. I really, really love having the flexibility and being able to live the life that I want. So I encourage you to do the same.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I got the book yesterday.
Yep, so, I saw that. Yep, it'll be shipping on Monday.
And then if you see that there's a couple girls on here, so we'll just share the link in the event. So I'll just, that link that you sent me, I'll just post it in the event. So Tiffany and Jamie, so that way you can get yours. So
awesome. It's a great read. It's very empowering. The reviews that I've gotten have been really great, you know, from Pure Romance Consultants and everyone else outside of that. And it was written for the non-reader. So for those that are like, you know, oh my gosh, I don't like to read, I promise you it's an easy read and you're not going to want to put it down.
Perfect. Well, thank you so much for your time. Thank you, hope you have a wonderful Sunday, rest of your Sunday.
Thank you, you girls as well.
Appreciate you.
I look forward to seeing some of you at national training, hopefully, okay? And, you know, I am a hugger, so, you know, I know we're in the midst of COVID, you know, but I'll be the one that it's okay that you can come and hug.
Oh, girl, I don't think anybody on our team is COVID scared. So
okay.
So yeah. All right. Well, you have a wonderful day. Thank you guys, and thanks everyone for being on as well.
All righty. Bye.